Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're someone who presents with PowerPoint, whether it's for school, work, or webinars, then you need to know about Presenter View. Presenter View in PowerPoint lets you see more than your audience. While your viewers see just the current slide on the projector or second screen, you get a private interface on your laptop with speaker notes, the next slide preview, and slideshow tools. This makes your presentation more confident and more professional. Let me walk you through how it works, step by step, and how to set it up the right way. To use Presenter View, you'll need at least two monitors connected to your computer. For example, your laptop screen and a projector or external display. As you can see here, I have three monitors connected to my system. Once they're connected, go to your desktop, right-click on an empty area, and choose Display Settings. From there, you can identify which monitor is which, their numbers and physical arrangement, and also set which one is the main or primary monitor. Now open your PowerPoint presentation and go to the Slideshow tab. In the Monitors group, you'll find a checkbox for Use Presenter View and a drop-down to choose which monitor should display the actual slideshow. By default, PowerPoint might select your primary monitor for the slideshow, but you can click the drop-down and choose which screen should show the slides and which one should display the Presenter View. This flexibility is super useful when you're presenting on different setups. Once Presenter View is enabled and you start your slideshow, PowerPoint splits your view into two screens. On your main screen, your laptop, you see the presenter view on the second screen, the projector or monitor. The audience sees only the current slide. The presenter view gives you a whole lot of features to control the appearance during the slideshow, as you can easily switch back and forth between the slides. You can also click See All Slides button to see a list of all the slides available in the presentation and jump to a particular slide. On the right side pane of the presenter view, you also have the notes section, from where you can read the notes during the slideshow and can also increase or decrease the font size as well. You can also switch back to the last viewed slide by clicking the three dots button. If for some time you wanted to hide the slideshow during the presentation, then you can easily toggle by clicking the black or unblack slideshow button. This feature is also available under the three dots settings button, from where you can also choose white or unwhite screen instead of black. Then you can use the pen tool in the presenter view to draw or highlight something in real time during the slideshow. Later, from the three dots button, you can hide or show the pen or ink as well. During the slideshow, if you wanted to focus and zoom a particular area of the slide, then you can click Zoom into the Slide button, and that will also give you the hand too that you can then use to move and focus to particular content on the slide. From the three dot settings button, you can also see the taskbar if you wanted to switch or open any another application during the slideshow. Show taskbar button is also available on top left of the presenter window. On top, you also have the Display Settings button, from where you can swap the monitors between the presenter view and the slideshow. Just below these buttons, you can also pause or restart the slideshow timer if you wanted to, and if you wanted to display the slideshow on all the monitors simultaneously, then just click the Duplicate Slideshow button from the top bar. It is also a good idea to check the slideshow configuration options from the File options, and then from the left side pane, choose Advanced. Scroll down to the Slideshow section, turn on the features as required, specifically Show Pop-up Toolbar and Show Menu on right mouse click during the slideshow, so if you are running the slideshow on all the monitors, then you can still control the slideshow from the pop-up toolbar or from right-click context menu. And that's everything you need to know about Presenter View in PowerPoint. It's such a helpful tool that once you start using it, you'll wonder how you ever presented without it. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a thumbs up, let us know in the comments how you use Presenter View, and don't forget to subscribe for more PowerPoint and productivity tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, and take care.